bend her on circles, so I'm pushing her off the rail there. That's a good one there. I like the position of her head now already. And up there and down.
Lower.
Good. But the lower. And then the main kind of. If she bought something, maybe you make a correction. You see? Now, anytime she does something you don't like, you gotta make some kind of correction. If you don't do anything, you're just as well saying, go ahead and do that, it's fine with me. And it's all about.
You notice she moves a little better laterally now.
Yeah, that's good. It's all about knowing how much pressure to add, whether you keep the pressure the same, or whether you lower the pressure. Good, that's a nice walk, good. But that's right, you're bending around circle and really make an effort for it. Good, Amanda. Yeah, she looks pretty supple. Good. Good. And then move her off the track again, and when you come about to the quarter line, then ask her to disengage your haunches and change direction. So you're going to come to the quarter line, slide your feet over, push her haunches around with your left leg. And your right leg kind of comes back and holds those haunches so she doesn't, you know, hurt that back. Good. That kind of looks good. Very good. Because all these little exercises, the goal is to get her neck and head. Okay, I'd like to yield her off the track. Good. And if she doesn't listen to your leg, the consequences are the spur or the whip. You know, she's well enough trained now that, you know, if she doesn't listen to a light leg, then she has to know that there's a consequence. Okay, leg yield her off. Good. Very good. Very good. Good. Here we go. Good, Amanda. Yeah. And push your back. Back is nice and straight. Even on a long frame, it's nice and straight. Good job. Very, very good. And then go ahead and pick up an object and do some pick up and release. So we pick up an object, you want to just hold a little bit so she flexes the pole, and as soon as she does, then you drop your hands and release. Good. Keep the head comes up. Remember, you squeeze in with those spurs. Good. Good. And then release. Good. So you pick them up. She's to come onto your hand. And if she doesn't, then you don't fit bang with the spurs. You just poke in. You keep pressing in harder and harder. Good. That's how to do it. Very good. And again, what you want her looking for is lightness. You want her looking for that when she's on the bit in light, the release. That's nice, Amanda. Good. Good. And then cross the diagonal, lengthen the stride, three walk. Good. That's nice. Good. Very good. Very nice. Good.
Sorry, I had to move my seat.
Leg yield off the wall here, And when you come to the quarter line, this is the line in the change direction. Remember, you've got to slide your right leg back, so when she's doing this, she doesn't drift out. That's good. That's very, very good. Very good. That's nice. And then put your marches around, and your reaction is pushing with your right leg. Very, very good. That's right. Now, if the head comes up, you don't give the reins. You know, you keep that hold until the head comes down. You don't want her to get the idea that all she has to do to get rid of your hand is raise her head. That's right. Good. Right. Very good. So whenever you're ready, let's do a trot in the 20-meter circle here. You know, you have your spurs. If she's light or she's heavy and she puts her nose up, you can just put it in there. That's right.
Yeah, well, that's how it goes. This is what we did last time too, like when we first start, that's
good girl. Good. Okay, so give it some time, take a little bit. Good.
Pointing it across.
Now, I'd like to see your hands in front a little bit more instead of back by the sand. Come down the quarter line. Push. Now, bring your hands out in front of you. Come down the quarter line so they're in front of the sand. And light heel. Good. Come down the quarter line again. Very nice rhythm. Looking pretty good there, lady. Good. Very good. And leg heel. Good. Very good. Keep it straight with that outside hand.
I don't know what you're talking about. I don't have a shoulder in. Yes, you do.
Yeah, but you really want to see our muscles then.
Very, very good. I thought she was very consistent on the bench. I thought your leg heel was good. Mm-hmm. I thought she looked really good. They're just showing 2 and 3.
Our bad direction, so
okay.
I'll take that. If we can get what we had tonight even,
yeah,
that would make me happy, but sometimes we have no stretch at all.
All right, Amanda, like I said, her most you know, one of the best dancers, and she's like, it's great. So your dad gets in on it, and she comes through again.
Right.
So whatever direction you enter, okay, you gotta decide, you need to bend her more, you need to push her with the outside leg more, you gotta decide what you need to do to get her on the center line. Because once she hits the center line, she's straight. So let's practice the center line.
Okay.
I think she looks very, very good.
Thank you.
Very good.
I had a good trainer in your absence.
Very, very good. And you know what, it's, I like the way that you and Chris, you know, experiment. You know, it can't just be what you read in the books. You have to try different things. Okay, so, yeah, now you just, that's right, good. Good, so.
Press the ball on those stirrups. When you do the trial, press down on the stirrups. You stabilize your leg, like you press down where it is. After the roll,
yeah, seriously.
Just like this. Okay, so where did you ask for the camera? The camera you asked for where?
Between A and F.
Okay, the most important thing about the camera is the mirror.
Just what I wanted.
Sure. So in test three, where do you ask for the canner?
Same place.
Okay. So do as much canner as you can do in test three. Remember your inside leg all the way into the canner is squeeze. That keeps the rhythm of the canner. And inside the thank you. you know, the transitions aren't bad. The upward one, she does pop into it a little bit, mm-hmm. Puts her head up. So you got to experiment with maybe bending her a little bit more to the inside. In other words, shoulder in, ask for a shoulder in position.
Okay.
Yeah, that. The downward, you know, keep your leg on her so she doesn't just drop into it.
Right.
You know?
I think we are the hardest part.
So the, you know, the center line, the piano, we're pulling in there.
Oh, our stretch is quite
long. Yeah, yeah.
She's getting better.
Yeah.
We've been practicing.
So.
Definitely better than it was. It's, well, I only did Rocky River this year.
Yeah.
And that was at that period of time. Right after I lost my dad, I got that. So.
I know, you did a rough one.
Not, but I did it anyway.
Did you take your Geritol today?
No, I did not. Smart ass.
Your Centrum Silver?
Put that on YouTube.
Have the nursing home incline your bed a little bit.
So it doesn't look like you're reaching.
Okay.
And sometimes in the skirt, just a little bit shorter, you know, we've got a big move around from here. We just, it helps you, it gives you a little more stable,
maybe right now that's where your nurse stirrups need to be. Oh, you want your whip back? You want your whip back? Don't you usually use your whip when you do this?
Yeah.
Do you want it?
Yeah. She needs a reminder.
Right.
Without cantering.
Okay, so the punch has got to be in, okay, and the bend has got to be to the inside. Amanda, you got to see her inside out. Okay. Okay.
yourself. A little bit more. Find this guy in more. Go nine in. There. Now came back to the wall. That's hard for her, isn't it? So maybe we need to do a step before that, like leg heels into the wall. Turn her into the wall and put her onto the stand with it. Onto the stand one. Or. Like that. Okay, then straighten her. Yeah, try to do it. Good, now straighten. The same thing over here. Head to the wall. And put her hind end into the press. Head to the wall. Hind end in more. Like that. Good. Good. And then come around the corner, shoulder in, and like you can try to do the same thing the other way. We had it start a little lower than that. Shoulder in a couple steps, and then plant it, push her in the length. Not length it across the diagonal. Can
you see it? Try that again, because I can't lengthen sitting yet.
Now we're going to do the head to the wall, and put her more to the press.
Like that.
Good. You got that on tape? Oh, yeah. Good. Okay, straight. Now that's how far the launch can be. Okay, get into the wall. And launch it into the track. That's right. Good. Press down the strokes. Good. Good, now straighten. Okay, and come around the corner, shoulder in, and straighten and lengthen. So shoulder in, straighten the diagonal. Shoulder in. Okay, then lengthen. That girl, that's good, Amanda.
So you know what, Amanda? Good, Amanda, yeah, good. Okay, then shoulder in. Boy, she's moving nice, isn't she, Chris?
Yeah.
Shoulder in. Good. That's a girl. That's a girl. That's a girl. That's nice. Good. Very good. Okay, then straight. Come down the neck along the side. Head to the wall on the center. Good. Head to the wall on the center. That's a girl. Keep your eyes clean up. Straight ahead. Good. Very good. 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 And then shoulder in. Cross the diagonals. Shoulder in, cross the diagonal.
That's not okay.
Shoulder in, and then straight your arm. Good job. Good. And now stretch your circle. Stretch your circle. Don't let her rush now. Slow your pose down. Bend her. Bend her with it. Yeah, like that. Yeah. Good. Good. That's right. That's right. Good. Keep your toe up. That's the girl. Bend her some more. There. Good. Good. Very good. Very good. Bend her. Don't wait the head. Play a little bit on that inside ring, but don't
hit fast.
Don't slide your hand up like this. Slide your hand down. That's right. Good. You know, slide your hand down the ring. That's right. But and when you do that, you got to put your leg like that. Good job. And transition to walk. All right. Very, very good. So I think instead of haunches in practice, then head to the wall with the haunches in.
Okay.
That'll be the first step to that.
Okay.
And work a lot on the flexing to get her so she's easy to bend around. I thought the on the bit was very good. I thought she was moving. The more you get the shoulder in and the head to the wall, the quicker she moves.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, for sure.
And I think it helped with those stirrups up.
Okay.
What do you think, though?
Yeah. Yep.
You know, you had more support. It didn't look like you were reaching for the stirrups when you were posting.
Okay. Remember, we talked about this before. I think it's kind of variable. Sometimes you need them a little shorter, and sometimes you need them a little longer. Just
for the support.
Just depends where you're.
Aren't you impressed? I can sit.
I think she's doing very well.
She's been working on her sitting trot.
Have you been taking lessons from? That's
no. I just yell at her.
You guys are a good team.
No, actually, one day I rode with her, and it wasn't even something I said I was going to work on.
Yeah.
I mean, obviously, it's been a goal.
Right.
But it wasn't like that day's goal. And for whatever reason, that day, it just clicked and made sense, and I have trouble getting it if I lose it.
Right.
But usually, if I start from the get-go, I can do it for a while until she gets really off balance. And
very good. And it helps if they're steady on the bit, you know? Remember with the canter, press, lift up, press, lift up. Keep your leg on her too so she doesn't drop. But, you know, when you think about it, Amanda, when was it that I first came that you weren't even cantering? When was it, in October?
No, we didn't start till November.
November.
Remember you weren't even cantering? Look how far your thumb was.
Mm-hmm. And you wouldn't go dare ride her with whip or with spurs.
And when you see how nice she looks in this
video, I look forward to watching the video because I haven't seen any of my video except the really bad show.